next topic we'll start with in trigonometry, trigonometric ratios and identities. Now before going to into that, what do you mean by angle first of all? The basic definition of angle from geometry is the union of two non-collinear rays. If I consider one ray over here, another ray over here, whatever here is nothing but the angle. So union of these two non-collinear rays is nothing but what? This angle. With this angle, the measure of the angle is always restricted between 0 and 180 degree. Does not matter whichever lines you join. We always get this angle in between what? 0 and 180 degree. The opposite angle may be called what? A reflected angle. So we can have angles at the most 360 degree. So I want to change this definition and I want an angle of any measure, any real number. Now to do this, we will define the angle in the following way. This is one ray, this is another ray. Likewise, I will choose only one ray over here, which is called initial ray. And what we do, we rotate this ray about this point, which is the end of the ray, either in anticlockwise direction or what? In clockwise direction. So if you measure the angle in anticlockwise direction, that angle is taken as positive angle. So if I do the rotation in anticlockwise direction, this angle is regarded as positive angle. Similarly, if I rotate this ray about the point O in clockwise direction, then I get the angle, say theta, in what? Clockwise direction. This is regarded as what? The negative angle. So this is the positive angle and this is what? The negative angle. Because of the rotation of the concept of this initial ray OA about the O in either clockwise or anticlockwise direction, I can rotate this ray number of times to get different kinds of angle, even more than 360 degree. How? So if I rotate this OA in anticlockwise direction, this is 90 degree angle, this is 180 degree angle, this is 270 degree angle, this is 360 degree angle, and if I again rotate this, I may say this angle is what? After first rotation, 360 plus 90, 360 plus 180, 360 plus 270, etc. So if I keep on rotating, right, this angle about the point O, I will be getting what? The angle of any measure. So we can have magnitude of the angle as any real number. If I rotate in the anticlockwise direction, it would be positive angle. And if I rotate this OA in clockwise direction, it would be what? Negative angle. So this is the new concept of measurement, defining what? The angle. So here the measurement of the angle or angle is of what? Any measure, isn't it? Here it is restricted between what? 0 and 180 degree. So that's why we have defined this definition. Now the next concept we define is the angle in standard position. What do you mean by an angle in standard position? Take x-axis, this is the origin, this is your y-axis. We know that the new definition of angle is, this is the initial ray and we rotate this OA about O either in anticlockwise direction or in what? Clockwise direction. And wherever we stop rotating or rotation, that becomes what? The terminal ray of the angle. So this is the initial ray and this is the terminal ray. Now this is called the vertex of the angle. Now if I keep my vertex of the angle at the origin and whose initial ray is along the x-axis, that angle may be called an angle in standard position. So angle in standard position is that angle whose vertex is at the origin and whose initial ray is along the positive x-axis. So suppose this is the vertex, take any point on the positive x-axis. So this becomes your what? Initial ray. Now rotate this ray either in anticlockwise direction or in what? Clockwise direction. Whatever angle suppose I get over here is AOB. This angle is called angle in standard position because its vertex O is at the origin and whose initial ray means rotation is started from the positive x-axis. If I consider suppose something like this, so this is say the point O, this is point say A, and if I start rotating this OA about O, this would not be called angle in standard position because this is not the origin. Origin is here, right? Similarly, if I consider origin over here and this is one point over here, suppose this is the initial ray and this is the terminal ray, this angle is not in a standard position because the initial ray OA is not along the positive x-axis. So vertex at the origin and the initial ray is along the positive x-axis, that means the angle is in standard position. Throughout the trigonometry we will consider angles of the trigonometric ratios in standard positions. Now let's go into defining the trigonometric ratios. We know from your 10th standard geometry, you have studied trigonometry. If you consider a right angle triangle, if you consider a right angle triangle, say A, B, C, and this angle is suppose theta, this is the side opposite to the angle theta and this is the side which is adjacent to the angle theta. This is called the hypotenuse, and we know that from trigonometry we define sine theta as opposite side divided by what? Hypotenuse. Similarly, we define cos theta as adjacent side divided by what? Hypotenuse. Then we define tan theta as opposite side upon adjacent side, etc. Now we are going to define, we are going to redefine trigonometric ratios of angles in standard positions using new concept. What is that concept? Let's see. Here, I will take the help of Cartesian coordinate system. Let us consider this as y-axis, this is x-axis. Choose any point P, xy in the plane. From that point we drop the perpendicular on the x-axis at say M. We know that this distance OM is nothing but what? X. Distance PM is nothing but what? The height y of the point P from the x-axis. Let us join this distance OP. I get OP is equal to square root of x square plus y square, because O is the origin, 0, 0, P is x, y. By distance formula, I get OP equal to root of x square plus y square. Let us say this distance OP is say R and this is the angle theta. Now notice that this angle theta is in standard position because whose vertex is at the origin and whose initial ray OM is along the positive x-axis. Now this is again a right angle triangle because I dropped the perpendicular from the point P on the x-axis. So right angle triangle is formed and this angle theta I am considering. Here I will define six trigonometric ratios of angle what? Theta. First, I will define cosine theta. Cos of theta, you know from trigonometric definition, it is adjacent side divided by R. So, this is x divided by R. But I am not going to look into this x as side of the triangle, adjacent side of the triangle divided by what? Hypotenuse. But I am going to consider this as x coordinate of the point P divided by distance of the point P from the origin. This is the new way of looking into cos of theta. So, cos of angle theta is defined to be x coordinate of the point P, which is taken anywhere on the terminal ray of angle what? Theta. So, OM is taken and it is rotated through an angle theta. On this terminal ray, you choose anywhere the point PXY, then x coordinate of the point P divided by distance OP is defined to be what? Cos theta or cosine of the angle theta. Similarly, we know that sine theta is y upon r. Sine theta is opposite side upon hypotenuse. But we are not going to look into this as opposite side upon hypotenuse, but we are going to look this as y coordinate of the point P divided by distance of the point P from the origin. That is nothing but what? Sine theta. So, sine theta is y coordinate of the point P divided by distance OP. Similarly, I would define tan theta as y by x. I am not going to disturb the definition of trigonometric. Same thing I am considering, only my way of looking is changed. So, tan theta would be defined as opposite side upon adjacent side, that is correct, but y is nothing but the y coordinate of the point P divided by what? X coordinate of the point P. Now, you may say, if I choose the point over here on this terminal ray, OP, suppose the point is Q, x prime, y prime. Would this tan theta change? Would this sine theta and cos theta change from my point of view or whatever I defined just now? From the geometry, we know the results of similarity. From that, one can say that there is no change in the value of these trigonometric ratios. Even the point P is shifted to the right or to the left of it on the terminal ray of angle theta. Because if I drop the perpendicular, this distance is what? Y prime, and this much distance is what? X prime. So, if I redefine tan theta, it would be y prime divided by what? X prime. So, question is, are these two things same? Yes, because we know that triangle OPM is similar to triangle OQN. So, triangle OPM is similar to triangle OQN. Therefore, this side divided by this side is same as this side divided by this side. So, as this ratio remains the same, so value of tan theta does not change. So, does not matter where you choose the point P or Q, anywhere on the terminal ray of angle theta, if the definition still remains the same. So, tan theta is the y coordinate of the point P divided by what? X coordinate of the point P. Similarly, we know that cot theta is defined to be x upon y, sec theta is defined to be r upon x, and cosec theta is defined as r upon y, which are just reciprocals of this. So, moment I choose three numbers x, y and r, there are six combinations by choosing any two out of them. So, we know that from this 3P2, right? 3P2 is 3 into 2 is equal to what? 6. So, we are getting from the permutations and combination. Cos theta is x by r, and another thing is what? R by x, which is defined as sec theta. sin theta is y by r. So if we take what r by y, it becomes cosec theta. New trigonometric ratio is defined. Tan theta is y by x and cot theta is x by y. So I have 6 permutations and combinations of the 3 numbers x, y and r in order to define 6 trigonometric ratios in this trigonometric ratios and identities. So cos theta, sin theta, tan theta, cot theta, sec theta and cosec theta, these are the 6 trigonometric ratios we have defined using what? The coordinate system.